Answered prayer naman ng isang kababayan dito sa Port Moody, British Columbia na makasama ang kanyang ina dito sa Canada matapos ang hagupit ng bagyong Yolanda noong Nobyembre. Ang kwento ng kanyang paghahanap at ng kanilang reunion sa report na ito. It took 7 days after Typhoon Yolanda struck before Bing Poblete heard news from Tacloban on her mother's safety. Poblete's mom Cora was living by herself. The wait was one of the most agonizing moments of her life.
She's 75 and she's most of the time alone kasi nga sometimes she has somebody with her, like yung house help. Sometimes naman wala. But the most that worried me was her condition kasi she has a heart condition. Hindi ko alam kung may food pa siya or may medication. Ganun. And if she was hurt, may makakapunta ba?
News came through a text message from one of her cousin's nephews. Her mom was okay, and that was all Poblete needed to know before flying all the way to the Philippines to get her.
Tinandaan ko yung sinabi niya, to be strong, ganyan. So ang kaba ko, nawawala.
Travel conditions were uncertain, but Poblete was determined. She was also optimistic after the Canadian government announced it will prioritize the processing of immigration applications from Pinoy significantly affected by the typhoon.
Basta magandang balita yon, you know, nadagdagan yung hope ko na okay, since she's one of those many victims. Mm-mm. At sinabi naman ng immigration, tutulong sila. So mas nabuhay na ako ng loob na I can bring her. Bahala na, basta kahit tourist visa. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then I'll just work on, you know, her permanency here.
Poblete submitted a handwritten certification from their barangay in Tacloban to prove her mother was among those affected in the areas badly hit by the typhoon. She also prepared supporting documents even before flying to the Philippines, like a notarized letter of support, employment certification, and their latest tax assessment. They applied for a tourist visa December 9. The embassy stamp shows it was granted the next day. Today, Poblete and her mom are together in Canada. They are hoping it will be for good.
I have all the paperwork for her permanent residency. We have a family na afectado, and gusto mong manatili sila dito. You know, you submit your application, and then, of course, you still have to go through the process.
The Canadian Embassy in Manila continues to prioritize applications of those affected by the typhoon. More than $20 million in humanitarian assistance has also been committed as Canada continues to monitor and work with its aid partners in the Philippines.